a rough childhood, rock and roll, drugs and alcohol rehab. It's a life which could have easily come to a sticky end. But has infamous Aussie rocker Jimmy Barnes gone from a working class man to a new age man? Jimmy sat down with Mark Crysell before getting in the kitchen for a good old trans-Tasman tussle over the Pav. It's an awesome catch-up, but just a word. Some viewers may find parts of his interview unsettling, including what went wrong in Auckland.
When you think Aussie rocker, you think Jimmy Barnes.
I'd have to scream for like an hour and a half before I went on stage.
Everybody knows Barnesy.
These days I don't have to do it as much, but and I'd do that for about an hour. Every time. I'd literally walk in. If I've had a lot of gigs in a row, sorry.
But it's no one-note wonder. Pokari Kariana, performed by the Barnes family alongside our very own Neil Finn and his whānau.
I think when I was 6 years old in the school choir, we sang Pokari Kariana. It's about, you know, longing for your family or your love across the water. And so I thought it was really fitting. And the Finns, you know, Neil and Sharon are like family. We call them the Finlaws.
Are you trying to become an honorary Kiwi? Are you interested?
I've been... Every single time I come to New Zealand, I want to buy a place here.
But Aotearoa is also an uncomfortable reminder of a darker time.
One of the darkest places was actually here in Auckland, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, absolutely. I'd been just taking drugs for years non-stop and drinking, and nobody could reach me, nobody could get to me. I had everything in the world, but I had nothing.
Alone in his hotel room in 2012, he attempted to take his own life.
And I remember thinking, how hard can it be to die? How hard can it be to die? Well, I'm here to tell you that it was a bit harder than you thought. And I think it was just one of those moments of madness, and I survived. I was lucky.
Jimmy Barnes' life story isn't so much the working class man who made it. He's the working class boy from Glasgow who almost didn't.
We were being abused physically, sexually, emotionally, at home, in the place we should have been safe. When I thought about that and then think about my parents, the thinking of the possibility they maybe knew about it, I found myself, you know, I went on the road to escape all that family and not be like them. And over the years, part of my discovery, that I found that I was becoming like them. Not violent in the same way, but I was becoming narrow-minded. I was just shutting down because of pain, because of trauma.
So did you ever think that your parents may have been going through the same thing?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I think they're probably going through worse. Really, they, with the tools they had, they did the best they could. But it wanted better.
He hit the road, became a rock star, sold out concerts, fan worship. But on the inside, he was at war with himself.
You know, there's a lot of stuff in my childhood that I didn't deal with. And as long as I didn't face it or deal with it, it was directly affecting me.
And then one day, he started putting it all down on paper.
And it like opened a floodgate, and all this stuff came back to me. And it was so painful. But at the same time, everything started to make sense. And I'd literally write a chapter in a book and then bring my therapist.
What resulted was two revealing, award-winning autobiographies.
Once I opened up about it, all these people stopped me in the street and go, you know, I went through the same stuff, you know? And you think nobody could possibly go through what you went through. And there's so many people out there living the same. And, you know, and even the shame of that growing up in with abuse and poverty and violence and alcohol and all that stuff, all these people, there's people today living in the suburbs of Auckland going through that right now.
Do you get a lot of people asking you to sign your book?
Sign the books? Yeah. I'll do it for them.
Will you sign mine?
Yeah, I can sign it.
Can you just say, you know, to Mark, yeah, I'd be nothing without you, or
Mark,
my inspiration.
You made me who I am.
Actually, it's life that made Jimmy Barnes what he is.
You are what you are, and everything every hurdle, everything that's been thrown at you makes you who you are. And sit and look at my life now and the family that I've got and the people that are around me, I wouldn't change anything. And so if I have to go through that again to do this, I would, you know, simple.
And it's a rich life that's given him 7 children, 15 grandchildren and 2 great-grandchildren, as well as hit albums. And when COVID and lockdowns hit, Jimmy and wife Jane continued to do what was important to them.
Come gather round people wherever you roam.
We thought we'll do a couple of songs, we'll send them out on the internet and it'll sort of help people connect a bit and all that sort of stuff.
Here we go. I see a bad moon arising.
And it sort of ended up being our sort of lifeline to the world as well. It was sort of, you know, we, Jane and I connected more as a couple. The music brought us together and it helped us reach out to our friends. And we ended up doing 200 songs in a year.
Hunkered down in his New South Wales home, Jimmy reconnected with his Scottish roots.
I started learning bagpipes. And I started learning bagpipes as a kid, but I wanted to learn more. I didn't get very good in the bagpipes.
How close, what are your neighbours like?
Are they... The neighbours are close enough to hear it. That's one of the reasons I wanted to take up bagpipes is because I want to be 80 years old. We live on the river, and I want to walk on the riverbank in my kilt and play bagpipes and drive the neighbours nuts. So far, so good. I'm successful. They're poor neighbours.
What the world was also able to see is one of the wild men of Aussie rock in the garden.
But they're just very wild. Look at them everywhere.
And cooking up a storm.
She reckons it's easy. She reckons you could train a monkey. That's why she's letting me do it.
Over the years, I've become a pretty good cook. I sort of work on, you know, I can get my way around the kitchen. A lot of the time I make it up as I go along. But, you know, but apparently the good cooks do that. Who knew?
Do you like pavlova?
I do like pavlova. Yeah, I do like pavlova. I've got terrible sweet tooth.
All right, and we got the pav for you.
Oh, good.
It'll be good, all right.
Jimmy, I would like to introduce you to Peter Gordon.
Got her?
We're fans. I'm a fan of his.
Yeah. Are you?
Fan. Yes.
Who better than one of New Zealand's greatest chefs, Peter Gordon, to prepare one of our most iconic dishes?
Now, Jimmy, I've got to ask you, where do you think the pavlova comes from?
Well, of course, we you know, like most things, Kiwi. We claimed it in Australia many years ago, didn't we? Can you tell me the real story?
In true Anzac style, we just get cracking.
This could be a disaster,
guys. Try not to poke your thumb through the middle, or maybe give it another crack.
You're worried, aren't you? This is going to be a disaster.
2 eggs and Peter Gordon. What could possibly go wrong?
How many people does it take to make a pav?
How many people does it take to crack an egg?
For Jimmy Barnes, there's no such thing as half measures. Full tilt boogie at whatever he does.
You really have a love of cooking, don't you?
I do, because I love good food.
1 tablespoon at a time.
It's like music, it's like art, it's like it brings people together, brings, you know, people this. Language of the soul, language of, you know, it's a way of communicating with, you know, my family, we, every night, since my kids are small, we've always made a point of every evening we have a meal together where we sit down at a table and that's where we, you know, that's where we communicate, that's where we meet.
Is it true you're going to put out a cookbook?
Yeah, Jane and I are doing a cookbook called Where the River Bends. It's coming out at Christmas. Jane does a lot of the recipes and I write stories for her. These are recipes that have held our family together for years. You know, food is the best thing. You know?
So is it family oriented? It's not fancy food.
It's not fancy food. We want recipes that people can cook and, you know, really good, you know, warm family food. Yeah. And then they're at 180.
They're at 180, and then as soon as it goes in,
rock and roller, family man, author, cook, pav maker.
Shall we try it?
Yeah, I think so.
Here's one we made earlier.
There's a lot more to Jimmy Barnes than meets the ear.
Here's to the Anzac spirit.
Yeah. Cheers. And good luck to your cookbook.
Are you still a working class man?
I'm absolutely. It's
because you sound like.
Burn it in my soul.
You sound like a new age man.
Well, I'm a new age man, but you know, you'd be surprised how many new age men come from the working class. We're new age working class men. That's a new album, I think.
Well, Jimmy's new album, Flesh and Blood, is out this week. And depending on the COVID bubble with Australia, his New Zealand tour will start in July.